All right, greetings, YouTube. Performance reviews, where I give you the review from the technician's point of view. And today, somebody was very brave because a company sent me a bagless stick vacuum, knowing that I take things apart and I have a background in vacuum repair. And I say this because they sent me a digital message saying so. This is from Lupe, or I'm going to probably call it Lupe. I'm from New Mexico, just the Virgen of Guadalupe sounds more familiar to me, so I'm going to say the loop. Looks like the dog has joined us as well. There's a nicer inner box. All right. Well, here is our Lupe cordless vacuum. It is very nice, minimalist packing. I do like to see the... And this is made in the People's Republic of China, though it says the weight here is 7.9 kg. However, on the box it says it's 8.6 kg, so there's some discrepancy right there. Unknown symbols right there. I don't know what alien language this is at all. Again, so that's what I got. There is a UPC. I was kind of happy to see that. So let's see what's in the box. Oh, we got some Tiffany color here in the box. Ooh, okay. I have to say, without talking about the price that they charge for these things, at least you're getting kind of nice packaging. Here is the battery right here. And there's a plug-in. It's kind of hefty. First, take a look at the cell. 2.5 amps, 32 volts. So that is the battery got. Now I don't see any way to check the charge, but presumably there will be. Let's take a look here. We got some stuff here. We got one of these. I can't believe they did this. This tool. This is a straight up copy from another manufacturer. And I guess the people who own the company, they do have a background with that other manufacturer. We do have at least this very strange dusting brush upholstery combo. We have a Eureka adapter, and then we have the power adapter, which I'm with ones for different markets. So apparently if I decide to travel the world, they got you covered. All right, that's kind of cool. I'm glad there's not an adapter or anything like that. Some companies do that. I forget what Chinese company was doing that. I'm glad to see they didn't just, they actually made their own. That's really nice. We have a manual. I'll be reading over that. Ah, we have the nozzle. Man, is that a strange nozzle. That is super weird. Okay, it's not sticky as reported. It's just like a cheap Mylar roller, and then they have... they didn't put a bristle in here. There's a space for a bristle, and this brush roller looks straight out of a robotic vacuum over here. Though I do like that it has center feed suction. Most curious neck, swivel neck. So that's interesting. Three prong release, and the machine is going to stand upright by itself, which is one thing I look forward to seeing, because a lot of stick vacuums don't do that. There is the machine itself. It's pretty big. But this is not a, this is a, you know, it's like a two-thirds size upright slash, you know, full size kind of, I don't know, it's an interesting size. In fact, that plugs in there, and then that hose goes there. All right, you have to, yeah, that could use some improvement, but I don't think you're going to be taking the battery out too much unless that you're buying a second battery. Almost no charge, so we're going to let that charge. Before we let it charge, I kind of want to just see, give you a tour of what's here, because it's all very alien, very different. So under the sticker, we have the dustbin release. All right, so here... All right, we have the filter grill. It's got some heft to it. I have to say that. Definitely feels a lot more solid than something, you know, like a Dyson. You know, the quality, it's going to be interesting. There's like a little shoot here in the Cyclone. The Cyclone makes no sense right now when I'm looking at it. Maybe it will make sense as I take this apart. Okay. I see what's going on here. So there is a Cyclone. There's a 4 Cyclone unit in here. That's good. We like to see that. And then you have it looks like a pod filter like you'd have on an intake on a car, just on a much smaller scale. So you have a double washable filter there. That should allow for a decent amount of airflow through there. I might actually have to break out my CFM gauge for this one. I do own one, believe it or not. So that is the Lupe. And these are the tools I got with it, the manual. And that's really all I got in this box. All right, I have charged the Lupe. So we're gonna turn it on and test its working vacuum here in a minute. I just wanna go over a quick like demo of what's here now that I've had a chance to like look at it a little bit off camera. You have a button in the rear that separates the top from the bottom. So it's kind of a lift away machine and that sort of thing. Kind of like the SIBO Felix, something like that. What an interesting design. The hose, I doubt it's even a meter long. It's very, very short. With that, as far as getting into the HEPA filter, it's a little teeny HEPA filter back here with a piece of foam in there. I'm assuming the foam is for sound reduction. You do have a gasket, and then you can actually see the ass end of the motor right here. That all clips together. Just want to give a quick idea of the size and shape of the Lupe next to some Henrys and some Mila, just to give you an idea how big or how small it is. These are the standard adapters I would normally use when trying to convert something so that I can test its working vacuum. In this particular case, Lupe has decided to use a really small diameter fitting. I don't have any adapter that will work, so we are going to have to resort to a little duct tape. So let's see how much working vacuum the Lupe gets. About 70 sealed, 20 working inches of water. So what we're seeing in terms of power compared to other machines, this is on par with something like the V11, V15. It's on par with Henry Cordless. It's not quite at the numbers that LG has, but they're somewhat healthy numbers for a cordless machine. Of course, a normal plugged-in vacuum is going to get above 30 on this gauge, usually around 40 to 50, and central vacuums would get like 80 to 90. All right, well, if you're familiar with performance reviews, you know that we're gonna use a studio microphone right now, and we're gonna do a pickup test. You're gonna hear the real sound of the machine. Now, if you hear some background noise, I am doing laundry in the background, so unfortunately, that is what it is. So let's turn it on. I'm gonna put it on high. After testing it with the working vacuum gauge, a low is not going to pick up this mess that I put down. I can just tell you that right now from experience. And I'm going to leave the roller on and see if it scatters debris. And I'm going to be feeling with my feet as well. So if that gives you the heebie-jeebies, you can fast forward that. First thing I noticed out of the box is this hose is really stiff. It isn't quite lay level with the floor at first. Let's turn this on. Let's see, we left anything behind. Little bit of flower scatter. So that's actually pretty good. And now I want to talk a minute about this nozzle because it makes relatively no sense to me. The more I look at it, the more infuriating it is for me.
So it's a double brush roller design. The default's on. And you have this soft roller. You can see there's a little bit of flour stuck to the soft roller. And the idea is that this is supposed to allow big objects into the vacuum. Of course, the problem with this is unless you have tile or linoleum, you can't actually use this on wood floor without it scratching the floor. I'm sure the manufacturer will argue differently, but I would not use this brush roller on hard floor. So then you're left with this thing kind of scraping against your floor. Again, it is soft and cushy, but you know, if you catch something like cat litter, sand, something like that, yeah, that's not going to be great. And the brush roller, it's got space for an extra two bristles that it doesn't have, or a squeegee, which I think is interesting. I wonder if they upgrade that later. Now, another thing I did notice, let me grab a coin real quick here, is that it comes apart real easy. They did manage to make it so you can take these things on and off relatively easy. So maintenance is, you know, doable. We can see right there, on the side. Wow, that was the first use of the machine. All right, so we got some felt things. Anyways, all very, very strange the way this was constructed. You know, the bearings came to me with no lubrication, so I'm gonna go put a drop of oil on these.
All right, I decided to put a drop of oil in the sleeve bearings on this. So these are something you're going to have to clean out the edges of the machine regularly. I would say probably at least once a month you want to peek in there with regular use. I know there's not a whole lot in the manual. The manual is very scarce when I was looking at it. I'll just post a link below to the PDF version, have you look in it for yourself.
All right, let's do a carpet pickup test. We've got flour, breakfast cereal, cat litter, and fresh pet hair. Let's see how it does. Again, I'm going to put it on high. A little bit of animal hair left. I swear I felt some cat litter in there, but I don't feel it now. And then a little bit of flour as well. So it did pretty good for a cordless machine on soft pile carpet. This machine was designed in Britain by some previous Dyson engineers. Dyson was not known for their carpet cleaning ability. Neither the Dyson or the Lupe have the Carpet and Rug Institute seal of approval. So as far as deep carpet pickup, we're gonna wait for my full review before I conclude that.
Well, as always, this is an unboxing video, not a full video review. I will be doing a longer term test on this. If you're new to the channel, I test everything for at least a month in my house and really bane it up, try to get it full, try to see what the expendables are like, see if I run into any troubles. So I will be doing a full review where I take the machine apart, take a look at it, see how it's made. So that is going to come up, so definitely hit that subscribe button. A thumbs up helps the channel out. If you really like what we're doing or you want more performance reviews, check out our Patreon, link below to that. In that Patreon, you're going to find exclusive content for Patreon supporters, early access, all sorts of goodies in there. So check that out. Thanks for watching, and big thank you to Lupe for sending me this to test.
Have yourself a wonderful day.